People often ask me, what's my favorite thing to see at the Field Museum? And I'll say something like Evolving Planet, or the Hall of Gems, where there's this opalized vertebrae of a plesiosaur, or those old school insect cases. But honestly, my favorite thing is the floor. You know there are fossils in these tiles? The very foundation of our museum is comprised of thousands of invertebrate fossils that hung out in an ancient ocean 325 million years ago that today is Carthage, Missouri. But the Wikipedia page for Carthage has no mention of a past any more ancient than the founding of its county in 1841. And today, Carthage is more notable for the fact that it's home to the Precious Moments Park and Chapel, and there's nothing about its role as an invertebrate hotspot back in the Carboniferous period, which frankly, I find to be far more compelling. 325 million years ago, that area was covered by an ocean, which was a long, long time ago. The world looked very different. There were some of the earliest horseshoe crabs, amphibians that were twice my height, and these shark-like things existed. Before they were fossils, these invertebrates, colonies of bryozoans, brachiopods, and starfish-like creatures, lived and died, and eventually were turned into stone, where they remained buried during the rise and fall of Dimetrodon, the dinosaurs, saber cats, and mammoths, and the rapid evolution of Homo sapiens, until 100 years ago they were lifted from a quarry, cut and polished, transported across state lines, and installed in the floors and stairs of this building. And although this space changes and transforms, these fossils will still be in the same place in the floor for as long as this building stands. More than 1 million people every year walk across them. My grandparents stood on them when they first visited Sioux nearly 20 years ago. I stood on them during my first intrepid voyage here. These fossils are little witnesses to every visitor and scientist and exhibition across an entire century. Most people who visit never notice the fossils in the floor, which is understandable since there are so many other things to see and conversations to have and objects to ponder. And I don't think their visit is any lesser because of it. But I do think it's the sort of profound detail that can really make you appreciate the fact that we're all on one planet together, and that there's only one planet we've all lived on together. Us and the mammoths and saber cats and dinosaurs and Dimetrodon, way back to 325 million year old colonies of bryozoans, brachiopods, and starfish-like creatures. What I love about museums is that this urge to seek out these smaller notes, these profound details that link us together across space and time, isn't at all unique to me. It's something that we all experience when we decide to visit a museum. We're each on a constant search for our own version of the fossils in the floor. Like, just an example, last year the most viewed blog post on the Field's website came from the collections manager of fossil invertebrates called The Beachgoer's Guide to Lake Michigan Fossils and Rocks. More than almost any other page, this is what piqued people's curiosity. I'm in love with the idea that you can visit a place like the Field and see the stationary fossils in our limestone tiles, and then walk outside toward the Adler Planetarium, and down the steps from the taco stand on the shore of Lake Michigan, you can find your own ancient world in the loose beach rocks. Reach down and pick up a handful, and you might come face to face with a fossil coral that's been on a 100 million year long journey to end up in your grasp. It might be the first time that that rock has been looked at and appreciated for what it really was.
It still has brains on it.